But here's something that's very important for us to understand. Experiencing doubt or wrestling with doubt is not sinful. It's not a sin. Willful, defiant unbelief, now that's a problem. But struggling, wrestling, experiencing bouts with doubt, that is not a sin. As a matter of fact, doubt isn't the opposite of faith. It's actually really a part of your faith. It's a part of it. It's an element of it. Those little arguments you have, it's a good thing. You know, we give our friend the benefit of the doubt. The reality is, doubt can be a benefit if it draws us closer to the truth and to God. You know, Frederick Buechner, I love how he says it. He says, whether your faith is that there is a God or that there is not a God, if you don't have any doubts, you're either kidding yourself or asleep. But here's my favorite part. Doubts are the ants in the pants of faith. They keep us awake and moving. They keep us to where, I'm not sure. I'm working out my salvation with fear and trembling. I'm always wondering. I'm always thinking, could I do more? Should I do more? What's going on here? What's going on? You know, the doubt, in my opinion, is proof that it matters, that you're thinking it through. Greg Laurie even says this when it comes to doubt. He says it's a catalyst to spiritual growth. And his quote is, sometimes we need to go through the foyer of doubt to enter into the sanctuary of certainty. Sometimes we have to hang out in the foyer or the lobby of doubt in order to make it through, to enter into the sanctuary of certainty. And so when we experience doubt, here's the point I want us to come away with this morning. First of all, as we all raised our hands, doubt is common. But here's the other thing. This from Genesis to Revelation is filled with men and women of God who struggled and wrestled with doubt. Filled with it. You think it was easy for Noah to build an ark for a boat for a flood that was coming when the guy had never seen rain yet? Do you think it was easy for Moses and the people to take a step on dry land across the Red Sea? Do you think it was easy for Joshua to walk around these impenetrable walls of Jericho and on the seventh day, seventh time, shout and blow a horn and the walls are just going to come down? Do you think it was easy for David to grab five smooth stones and take down a giant that nobody wanted? Do you think it was easy for Abraham to go to a land that I will show you? I'm not going to send you a map. I just want you to go. And I'll let you know when you get there. Do you think it was easy for Sarah, who was in her 90s, to have her first child? Do you think it was easy for Mary, who had never had any sexual relations with a man, to be told that she is now greatly with child and the child happens to be the Son of God? Do you think it was easy? Do you not think there was some doubts?